Hello, I'm Dr. Arun. I'm a consultant in internal medicine at Royal Care Super Specialty Hospital in Coimbatore. And over the next few minutes, I will discuss a few aspects of one of the most important diseases that confronts our society today. We shall discuss a few aspects of hypertension. We call it systemic hypertension in our parlance, and in layman's term, it's usually termed blood pressure. Of course, we all need blood pressure, because without blood pressure, we'll all die. Because if you consider the way we work, the primary function of the heart is to maintain blood pressure. What it basically does is that it pumps blood into blood vessels, which then reach every single cell in our body. Without this, we cannot function. It is very specifically concerned that in India, we have almost 25% of us who have high blood pressure. What do you mean by high blood pressure? So when you go to a doctor, when we usually take our blood pressure, they give you a couple of readings. So it comes round about like 130 over 80. So you got a blood pressure value above and a blood pressure value below, divided by a single line, right? See, we call it systolic and diastolic. The upper aspect actually denotes systolic pressure, and the lower one is the diastolic pressure. Normally, we tend to accept blood pressure till about 130 over 80, and in older patients, we might even accept about 140 over 90. Anything beyond that, we call it increased blood pressure or systemic hypertension. The reason that we are discussing this today is because of the rampant incidence of this high blood pressure in India. As I told you earlier, 1 in 4 of us have got this increase in the blood pressure. Previously, this was prevalent more in the urban areas, but worryingly, now even people in rural areas tend to have high blood pressure. Now, what is the reason? Why is that suddenly in India we have this peculiar problem? Well, to be honest, it is not a problem that confronts India alone. High blood pressure is increasing throughout the globe, but this increase is sharpest in our area. The reasons are not very difficult to fathom. One of the very important aspects of blood pressure is that with increasing age, when our blood vessels stiffen, blood pressure increases. So there's nothing we can do about that. The other important aspect is that we eat more. Not only do we eat more, the quantity has been increased, but the quality of what we eat has also become very poor. We have tried to ape the West. We eat a lot of fast foods. What do they basically contain? Almost all the fast foods contain enormous amount of salt. That is one of the prime reasons that we find ourselves in this scenario where we have such a high degree of blood pressure. Normally, we require no more than 5 grams of salt per day. Anything over that will cause increase in the sodium in our body, which will increase the water retention and subsequently blood pressure. The factors that lead to high blood pressure also lead to bad and high cholesterol levels, our diet. So these are all interlinked. So high cholesterol levels lead to high blood pressure. Similarly, the other explosion has been in the field of diabetes. We seem to have a lot of diabetes. Diabetes is also linked to having high blood pressure. And we also tend to have more stress, less exercise. Is there no way to prevent this? There are umpteen ways to prevent this. Just reverse all of that what I've told you prior to this. Age is something you can't do anything about. The other things can all be modified. We can all improve the way we eat. We can reduce the amount of salt. We can reduce the amount of fat that we eat. We can reduce the amount of fast foods that we eat. We can increase fruits. We can increase vegetables. We can exercise more. We can lead a fitter life. We can smoke less. We can take alcohol in moderation. So all of which can be done to reduce the incidence of blood pressure. However, even after all this, we can still develop blood pressure. Now what do we do about that? There are a lot of myths surrounding blood pressure. One of the important myths that has come to be associated with blood pressure is that it is not very serious. Nothing can be further away from the truth than this. Blood pressure throughout the world is one of the most important reasons for premature death. It primarily strikes the kidney, where you can have renal failure. It can strike the heart, where you can get heart failure, and you can get stroke. So these are the three important areas where a person with high blood pressure can develop problems. It is very important, therefore, to treat blood pressure. And the other aspect, of course, I told you earlier, is to change the way we eat. So once you have high blood pressure, you can start by reducing, you can start treating them by reducing body weight. You can start treating by changing the way we eat, and again stopping smoking, drinking alcohol in moderation, reducing stress by yoga or whatever, and more importantly, exercising. So we need aerobic exercise to reduce blood pressure. Aerobic exercise is nothing. You can just walk fast for half an hour daily. Even that confers very important reductions in blood pressure. If after exhaustion of all these lifestyle modifications, we still find that the blood pressure remains high, then it is extremely important that we treat blood pressure with medications. Your doctor might prescribe one single medication, or if your blood pressure remains very high, we can start with a couple of medications right at the onset. Remember, treatment of blood pressure, and for that matter diabetes, which we collectively call silent killers, are not just the work of doctors alone. It's not like any other disease where the doctor can give you medicines and reduce the disease. These two diseases, and diabetes and hypertension in particular, requires the cooperation of the patients. Without the patient's cooperation, there's no way a doctor can treat your high blood pressure. So to summarize what I've been talking for long, hypertension is a very silent disease. It has got enormous amount of complications. Most of the complications are life-threatening, and we have a lot of patients with hypertension. It's extremely important that we work to prevent hypertension from occurring in the first place by adopting healthy lifestyle, healthy diet. And even despite all this, if we still get blood pressure, it's very important that we get checked for our blood pressure, and we get treated, and we follow the doctor's advice carefully. Thank you.